Dear friends, I would like to thank the friends of the School for Social Studies to invite me here to speak on the occasion of the Chintan lecture. The work, the sacrifice, and the legacy of Comrade VPC. Here would have had the privilege of working with Comrade VPC, or at least being led by Comrade VPC. I myself had the privilege of meeting Comrade VPC on many occasions. He was the most inspiring leader. Not only was he in the front line of building the working class movement in the state of Tamil Nadu, but also by his personal courage and example, he showed the difference between the politics of a communist and those of other parties. Particular qualities I would like to recall today. The first is his ideological commitment, his constant work in the field of ideology, theory, and understanding the practice of Marxism, Leninism in Indian conditions. Today, when ideology itself is being marginalized or being trivialized, I think the importance of an ideological clarity, a theoretical framework for our work, as Comrade VPC believed, I think that is one of the lessons we must learn from the life of this great revolutionary. The quality of his many talents and qualities was his ability to work and develop young people. I remember, even in those days, where there were so many militant class struggles which he was leading, he was specifically committed to identifying young cadre, growing cadre in the party, to spend time with them, to look after them, both ideologically, theoretically, and politically. And at the same time, their personal problems, their personal needs, the issue of building up cadre and cadre policy for a communist party is critical for our development. And I think today we have a great deal to learn from and be inspired by Comrade VPC's example. And so I pay tribute to the memory of our leader, our working class leader, our revolutionary leader, Comrade VP Singh, and we must pledge today to take forward his revolutionary legacy. My dear friends, as our president of this function has said, that we can discuss a topical issue like that of the currency ban, and then we can come to other issues which are part of the Hindutva agenda, including the Uniform Civil Code. He has set a new record in the whole world. Earlier, his friends had said, through the mass yoga program, the largest number of participants in any one yoga program under the great leadership of Narendra Modi, we came into the Guinness Book of World Records.
Now what is record?
Sadhane.
Sadhane. Now, there is a new sadhane. Huh? What is that sadhane? In the whole world, Modi sadhane. Crores and crores of people standing in the queue in the bank. Bank sadhane. Queue sadhane. And the best sadhane is, when you go to the bank, You cannot withdraw your own money. That is the Guinness Book of Records of Mr. Narendra Modi. Now suppose you are not well, suppose you are ill, and you go to the doctor to get better. Suppose the doctor says all your blood, 10% of your blood is bad. Then the doctor takes out 86% of your blood and puts back 5% of your blood. What will happen to you? You will die. You will take the doctor to the consumer court and you will get full compensation, your family. What will we do with Mr. Modi? In our economy, 1,000 rupee notes and 500 rupee notes constitute 86% of all the cash in the economy. 14 lakh crore rupees. Now in one jhatka, what is jhatka in Tamil? Mean one blow, one time.
Vare adil.
Vare adil. In vare adil, 14 lakh crore rupees were made illegal. Naturally, that is going to have a most disastrous impact on the economy. India is a cash-based economy. In India, whether it is in rural India, whether it is in urban India, the large mass of our people deal with cash. Every day, we are dealing with cash. In India, only around 3% of our population are dealing with plastic, which means credit cards, debit cards, e-marketing, e-wallets. So only 3% of the entire country's population is dealing with non-cash, cashless economy. Now Mr. Modi, he is traveling so much in the air nowadays, he has forgotten which economy he is living in. He is not living in a cashless economy. He is living in the cash-based economy of India. That is what Mr. Modi has forgotten. The CPIM and the left parties have opposed this move of the Modi government. The three aims of this government, declared aims: one, that it will stop black money; two, that it will stop counterfeit money; three, it will stop terrorist activity. Our party and the left believes that this move will not achieve any of these three objectives, and on the contrary, it will divert attention from the basic steps required to achieve these objectives. We are against black money. It is the CPIM and the left parties who have, in an uncompromising manner, fought every aspect of the black money economy. When the BJP in Madhya Pradesh was indulging in the Vyapak scam, taking black money for educational institutions, who was fighting it? The CPM and the left. In Bellary, in the big mining scam in which BJP leaders were involved, and today they have a 500 crore wedding of their daughter, who was fighting against black money? It was the CPM and the left parties. In West Bengal, Narda Sharda, the chit fund scam, who fought against it? It was the CPM and the left parties. In all these scams, it was the BJP leaders, many of the BJP leaders and some other party leaders, who were involved in these scams. So as far as black money and the fight against black money is concerned, it is the left parties who have the most credible record of fighting against black money. Today, Mr. Modi, is using emotion instead of logic to justify his move.
இன்றைக்கு மோடி அவர் எடுத்த நடவடிக்கையை தர்க்க ரீதியாக நியாயப்படுத்த அவரால் முடியவில்லை. ஆகவே உணர்ச்சிகளை வெளிப்படுத்தி அதை நியாயப்படுத்த முயற்சிக்கிறார்.
One day he is crying in Goa, saying, I have left my house, I have left my home to work for the country. Are Modi ji, till you became Gujarat Chief Minister, you were not working for the country, you were working for RSS. Better you say and cry that you left to work for the RSS. He is saying, please give me 50 days, then you can punish me, you can hang. I am going to be killed because I have taken this
motion
stand.
Motion can be no substitute for logic.
So let us come to the logic or illogic of his decision.
Question is, how much black money is estimated to be in the economy?
Because it is hidden money. There are many estimates.
Some say it is 20%, some say it is 60%. Of the GDP.
Official committees.
இந்த மதிப்பீடுகளை நான் சொன்ன மதிப்பீடுகளை செய்தது அரசாங்கத்தினுடைய அதிகாரப்பூர்வமான குழுக்கள்.
So there is approximately between 27 lakh crores to 50 lakh crores in the black money
economy.
Second question is 27 lakh crores to 60 lakh crores kept in 500 and 1000 rupee notes? Of course not. The amount kept, where is the black money kept? According to the official committees which have been set up by the government of India, accepted by the parliament of India, around 3 to 5% only of black money is kept in cash.
To a committee in 2012 set up by the government, it was headed by the chairman of the Central Board of Direct Taxes, and that committee said that the most important or the most significant avenues for keeping black money in the Swiss banks, in foreign banks, in gold, in land, and such like assets. Therefore, my dear friends, if you want to attack the black money economy by just thinking it is kept in cash, it is nothing but fooling yourselves and fooling the people, because out of 50 lakh crore rupees, only about 3 to 4 lakh crores is actually kept in cash. Therefore, this is not a step, as had been pointed out earlier by many official committees. Currency ban cannot be the objective and cannot fulfill its objective, for the simple reason that the black money, the bulk of the black money, is not kept in cash. Now, there was a man called Babban, and he went to a desi doctor.
Went and said, Doctor Saab, my leg has become blue. He said, Arey, it's become blue. That means it is full of poison. Better cut it off. Then he cut it off. After a fortnight of recovery, he again went, Mr. Babban again went to the doctor and said, Doctor, my other leg has also become blue. He put two false legs on Babban.
He said, what has happened, Babban?
He said, Doctor, the wooden leg has also become blue.
Thought and thought and thought.
Doctor, Babban,
now I understand the reason.
Babban, இப்பதான் எனக்கு புரிஞ்சது காரணம் என்னன்னு.
Nothing wrong with your body.
உடம்புல எந்த கோளாறும் இல்லை.
Your lungi is only making the blue. Mr. Modi and his government, he is cutting off the legs of the Indian economy, and later on he will say, oh ho, no, no, Vijay Mallya is sitting in London with the money, but I have cut off the legs of the Indian economy. That is what we are going to hear. The fact is that this is not going to achieve any of its objectives. Carry bundles of cash. Found, informed by the security forces in Kashmir,
of Mr. Modi's announcement. It's an incident near the border in Bandipur. It was found on their bodies that they had notes of 2,000 rupees cash on them. The new note which was given only 2 weeks before. It is not a question of currency notes. It is a question of the systems which are supporting the terrorists. So by banning the currency, you are not going to finish terrorism. You have to get your intelligence agencies to work. You have to get your official investigation agencies to work. And that is the key in the struggle and the fight to eliminate terror. Whole of India is against terror. Whole of India is against terrorists. But Mr. Modi, don't make false claims that by banning currency, you are going to fight terrorists. That is not going to happen. It is not happening. About counterfeit currency. What is nakli?
Kalla nota.
So we know about kalla nota. The same machinery which can make kalla 500 rupee note or kalla 1000 rupee note, that same machine will make kalla 2000 rupee note. Huh? So what is, unless you understand and identify the process and the culprits, by changing the currency, you are not going to hit at the root of the problem. To add salt to our wound. What is salt to the wound? Uppa in the ghaum.
ஏற்கனவே காயம்பட்ட இடத்துல உப்பு வச்சு தேய்ச்சா எப்படி இருக்கும்? அப்படி ஒண்ணு நடந்திருக்கு. தமிழ்ல அதுக்கு வெந்த புண்ணில் வேல் பாய்ச்சுவதுன்னு வேற சொல்லியிருக்கோம். ஆங்கில பழமொழி வந்து காயத்துல உப்ப வச்சு தேய்க்கிறது.
You understood, huh? Okay. Should I say it in Tamil? So, they are insulting us. 71 people have died standing in the queue. But that is not the inconvenience, standing in the queue. I already told you world record is there. Well done, Modi. I'm not saying standing in the queue. But they have destroyed livelihoods of crores of people. Crores of people. Their livelihood is destroyed. Into those details, you know it. The latest figure is Engineering Export Promotion Council of India has said that in the four major employment generating sectors, textile, garments, leather, jewelry, in 1 week 4 lakh jobs was lost. In the last 2 weeks, 6 million workers in these industries have not been paid their wages. 20 lakh plantation workers. As Vijayji had said, 90% of India is in the unorganized sector, dealing with cash. It is all ended. And yet Mr. Modi says it is pro-poor. Pro-poor about this policy. They, my dear friends, the same banks in which we common people are depositing our money, those same banks, under the direction of the government, have given loans to the corporates and big business, of which today 11 lakh crore rupees of loans given to these sections have not been paid back to the banks. If a farmer, a student, a small shopkeeper takes a loan, does not give it back, they will send notice to you and get your property. 1 year, 2 lakh crore rupees loans have been forgiven to the big business and corporate. Vijay Mallya in London, he was given the gift of 1200 crore rupees write-off of his loans by the bank. Our money, which is being forcibly by Modi, forcing us to put in the banks, it will help the banks to balance their balance sheet, to show profit on their balance sheet, And then again, with our money, again they will give the loans to the defaulters and say, this is the way of doing ease of business in India. Know about political corruption. Black money was used by the BJP and the RSS in the last Lok Sabha election.
Court has said
about the petition which is there before it, it needs more material.
This
the CBI raid on two companies, Birla and Sahara, a list was found of political leaders and an amount of money was put against their name.
2013, CB,
one name common on both lists, CM. CM in 2013, money against his name. In the Sahara list, 55 crores. Tell us about black money, Mr. Modi. The master of black money. We demand investigation into that case. Criminal prosecution in that case.
Criminal
hate black money. We want the government to publish all the names of all the account holders in Swiss bank and Panama papers. Go to the bank to take our money. They put a black mark on our finger. Black money with black faces. Their names are concealed by this Modi government. Publish their names. Put an end to all this double taxation agreements of tax havens which help these people to conceal their tax evasion and their black money. Not need to be taught nationalism by these people. Who opposes their policies, they say anti-nationalists. People standing in queues, anti-nationalists. Jobs are being lost, anti-nationalists. Will be felt for many months and years. We have demanded that till such time as a proper system is in place, the government must allow the use of 500 rupee notes and 1,000 rupee notes. India tomorrow, there are going to be protests. There will be strong protests because in Kerala, the rural cooperative banks where 2 lakh crore rupees of the poor people are invested, they are not allowed to do any currency exchange. In India, there will be protests and demands. We must ensure through our unity that this wrong step against the interests of the poor, against the interests of the Indian economy, against the interests of India, has to be prevented. It has to be, at least till the system is put in place, the 1,000 and 500 rupee notes must be allowed to be used. Those are our demands. And on this occasion, I request all of you to join this campaign, to join this struggle, so that we can force some sense into this RSS BJP government.